My name is Pavel. I work in Finam, and I successfully implemented such technologies as message-oriented middleware, enterprise service bus, business process management, complex event processing, enterprise architecture practice. And today, let me present how we are using WSO2 CIP solution in our company for fraud prevention. What is Finam? Finam is an investment holding consisted of several brokerage companies, bank, and asset management company. It is a national leader and global broker in the field of investment services. It operates in Russia, USA, Europe, India, China, and other countries. It has more than 300,000 clients in 40 countries with financial instruments market turnover more than $1.2 trillion. The company gives the client opportunity to be investor and to make deal, make orders and transactions in most world exchanges. The client, a client can be anywhere, at home, at work, at travel, and from anywhere he has access to make a deal on any stock exchange using the mobile application or desktop application. Apart from clients, broker, and stock exchange, there are two other parts that can influence the business. One part is fraud. These people who wants to steal money from client accounts. And second one is the regulator, who describes the rules on financial markets. About fraud. Most attacks are targeted to client terminal. Some attackers try to steal password or keys of trade of client terminals and start use it from another device. For this case, it is possible to detect parameters of client device and information about changing it. Another attacker tried to get control on trade terminals on a client device and make operation directly from it. In both, in both cases, when somebody obtained access to GT trade account, he will try to move money from one account to another account. In this case, we can detect changing of trading behavior, such an unusual volume, instruments, or frequency. If you combine these two detections, we can improve signal about SIF activity. Regulatory rules. These risks are mostly referred to the company, because all brokers must observe the financial rules financial regulatory rules. Stock market manipulation and insider trading are the biggest group of illegal trading practice. Some sets of illegal orders can be done within milliseconds. You can see spoofing, pump and dump, and other algorithms. And some of illegal practice can be done within hours or days. We have several basic data sources from exchanges, from trade platforms, and other data sources. From exchanges, we get information about market data and orders and trades. From trade platform, we get information about client events such as access, orders. And from other systems, we get information about any other events, such as the news. So we have up to 1 million stock data changes per second and up to 25,000 deals per second. All events are need to be analyzed before to be analyzed to get an alarm signal. For this task, I choose to use a CIP decision because it works in real time. It can work with many streams. It can correlate events between streams. After we had chosen this type of solution, we had compared several CIP platforms, and we had chosen WSO2 because it has very good performance tests, it has very good documentation, it is open source decision, and we presented it to management, and we had decided to start a pilot project. In the the first task you need to do when we start when you start using this solution, you need to integrate your data with this solution. In the our company, we have two transports for market data. One transport is gRPC, and second transport is GMS. gRPC is a Google Remote Procedure Call. It allows organized fast point-to-point integration between application written on different languages, such as C++, Java, and JavaScript. For gRPC, we wrote a small converter. It transformed gRPC protocol to Swift protocol. It works fast and does not create any essential delay. CIP has several inbuilt transport adapter, GMS adapter, and Swift adapter is two of these adapters. So events from GMS channel can be directly sent to WSO2. Other data streams come from any other data source types, such as database, files, and other messaging systems. And in this case, in these cases, ESB does its job. It integrates all types of incoming data, enriches data with any additional information, such as GeoIP data, geolocation, and sends data to complex event processing using GMS transport. When CIP generates an event with an alert, it sends it to ESB using the same GMS transport. The ESB routes the alert to right system. It can be CRM, BPM, risk system, or trade system, a trade platform system. Before CIP will generate a signal, all incoming data must be analyzed. Any CIP solution provides such functionalities, such functions as transformation, filter, correlation data between several streams, aggregation events from several streams to one event. WSO2 CIP provides the same functionalities, but with using inbuilt language, Sithi, the analyze can be done very quickly. Some of best specifies of Sithi we found when we started using it are SQL-like language and time intervals window. And main property is it is very easy to learn for any software developer. Some words about learning. WSO2 has a very good detailed documentation. So we spent only 3 days to connect data stream, to connect our data streams to CEP via GMS transport, 3 days for gRPC transport, and we spent only 5 days to learn Sithi and write our first script. So after 11 days, we had got the working version of our first fraud detect project. So let me tell about several use cases where CIP used now or will be used in the nearest future. First example is a market manipulation type. One type of market manipulation is spoofing. In this case, a client places a first small order. After he places a technical big order in opposite direction to first order, then he waits for execution of first order and immediately closes technical order after execution of first order. In this case, we have three actions from one client or from one group of clients to win one security. And time between these actions can be several or tens milliseconds. And we successfully find such type of market manipulation. Second use case is about access event. Client can generate several access event. For example, from internet bank access, from trade terminal access, from bank card usage. Each event comes with IP address. Using IP, we can determine geolocation. And if we found that the user had two or more access activities from different places with long distance between them in short time period, we will generate alert signal. For example, user cannot have a speed more than 1,000 kilometers per hour. Next case, like I showed above, CIP can detect a connection from unusual device or from unusual, in unusual time or location. Also, CIP can detect unusual order properties, such as unusual big volume of trade operations, unusual instruments. And when CIP detects both, it generates an alert for our operators. Another type of use cases is correlation data from stock market data streams and from news. For example, Complex 7 processing framework can detect price changing of any company. And at the same time, it can detect increasing of referrals count of the company in the blogs, in the news channels in last 20 minutes. Combination of these events may generate a signal to trader to help him in choosing right tactics. With CIP, we can simplify by monitoring news channels to detect negative information about our company and prevent it in the start. For example, we can found messages from news channels with our company name and with negative words. And if you found several times these messages in the last hour, we can send a signal to our marketing department. Conclusively, I have shown you how using of CIP, ESB, and BPM solutions, and we have planned using of machine learning decisions. You can help your business improve using of existing data and open new perspectives and possibilities and to do it quickly. Thank you.